welcome you to Atlanta and the Georgia Dome. And now we bring you the coin toss. It's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Smith is lined up and just about ready to send this one off as we're ready to get this game underway. Williams from the two. He makes it to the 25-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
Brown brings him down at the 26-yard line. That brings up second and nine.
Makes it to the 37.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Quick pass, knocked out of bounds at the 50-yard line.
Tight ends can really be a wild card in any offense. Sometimes the defense are a little bit confused on how to handle them.
Porter, the ball carrier, he gains a couple of yards on the carry. We've got third and 12, ball on the 48-yard line. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's at the 40. And he's taken down at the 25. How about that pass play?
Woo, great call. Let me tell you, talk about dangerous. When this tailback gets in the open field, woo, good luck trying to stop him.
They give to the tailback. He takes it right side for a good game.
That's a gain of seven on the play. That'll make it second and four.
And they'll get him in the backfield. They'll line it up again on third down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He throws a dart to the left. The defender had it and then dropped it. Nice play by the defense to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, instead of going for the interception, they did the safe thing, and that was just to tip it away.
UMass could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it splits the uprights. UMass lines up for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 25-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Taken down around the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. Makes it to the 44.
That's a gain of eight on the play. That makes it second and two.
Irby, this guy headed to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. We don't know how bad it is, but right now it doesn't look like he's likely to play any more football.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 44-yard line, third down. Little handoff. Gets to about the 47-yard line.
Really strong run to get the yards they needed for the first. I've seen way too many offenses airing it out on third and short and failing. I just have to sit there and scratch my head sometimes. Good call.
Nice run there. Gore picks up about 7 yards on the run. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And down he goes, around the 46-yard line.
No gain. That makes it third and three.
Tight right. Four down. I got number 18. I got you, 18. Hey, set. Sam, 10-19. Motion.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. Here's the eighth play of the series. Tackle left side after a nice pickup.
Team 7 on the play. That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Outright, and he's met for a loss.
If you don't get the blocking on the outside, the toss play is going to fail 99% of the time.
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Watch the run. Mike 50.
Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Makes it to the 14. Unbelievable. They can't get this offense off the field.
Oh, they've been like a machine on this drive. Very methodical and efficient. And once again, they're moving the chains.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. And they get nice yardage on that run. Not a lot of offense in quarter number one, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. UMass has got a 3-point lead. Back to the action now here in the second quarter.
Four down. Hey, check. Mike 50. Down.
Toss, left side. Touchdown, Georgia State.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
And he adds the extra point. So a 13-play, 74-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 26.
Returns 26 yards.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Gets him open field. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards.
Get out.
That makes it second and two.
He makes it to the 35-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards.
On the ball.
That'll make it third and one.
Brought down at the 31.
Loss of 4 on the play.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. Kerr fields at the 29. Breaks away from one, and now he's got the corner. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Georgia State is up by four. Quick shot, the defender tips it away.
He's got to be more careful with these rainbow passes. You don't want to give the defenders enough time to catch up with the ball and make the pick.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll make it 35.
Roger.
Let's go. Set. Looks to the back and can't connect.
For the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up 4th and 5.
Anderson is the punter. Oh, excellent punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and he's tackled at the 41. What a pretty pass play.
This is just a simple play-action pass. The defense here bit on the fake just enough, allowing the quarterback to find an open target, and the result is a big gainer.
They'll bring him down around the 31-yard line.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it 2nd and inches.
Here's the call from the referee.
Delay of game, offense.
Well, that penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So they have a 2nd and 5 following the penalty. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
Gain of 10 yards. First down.
And they make the stop around the 18-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a 1st or 2nd down play.
Gets rid of this one. So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Pitches it. He's got the corner. He gets out to about the 18-yard line.
No gain on the play. That'll make it 4th and 2.
Hot! push out of bounds, setting up a first and goal.
That's good for a gain of 16 yards. That makes it first and goal.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
Well, Kirk, good news. We saw him go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, but apparently he's all right. It looks like he's going to get back in the action here.
He dives, and he'll be marked down. UMass just took their first timeout. From the one-yard line, second down. Touchdown, Minutemen. Just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
Trying to go up by three. They'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point.
A 10-play, 84-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Kerr fields it at the two. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Almost picked off. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. Pass complete and taken down immediately. Now he tries to buy some time.
Tackle around the 37-yard line.
That's cutting it really close. But they converted on that run by an eyelash.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. He's tackled at the 47-yard line.
Georgia State's going to have to use their second timeout of the half.
Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Bowman was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and inches.
And he is drilled at the 39. UMass will have one timeout remaining.
Kirk, good news. The guy that we saw go to the locker room with that injury earlier is back on the sideline, and I got to bet he's going to be back in the game soon.
Tackle made to the 33-yard line. Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless. The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
Defensive dominance through two quarters of play. We go to halftime. UMass leads it 10-7.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref
signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.